This is a brief video on our M134 minigun clutch spacers, how they work, and why you need one. We have a post-sample M134 minigun here to use that we're going to show you. And as you can see on the back of this, we have a General Electric clutch that is set up. Before we get into the technical aspects of this and how these install, let's go look at the spacers themselves. All right, there's two types of spacers here. They're both the same material. They're made out of aluminum, and they have an anodized finish on them. We chose anodization because it would be most durable. You can see the difference here are cosmetic. This rised portion is a little longer than on this side. The reason for that being is, and we're going to explain this later, you're going to be running a tab on the back of your clutch. The tab is to prevent the clutch from spinning. And there's different types of tabs. This is a GE style tab here. As you can see, there's two holes in it, and that's going to sit right there, which is why there's a difference in height. This second design here is the same concept, except there's different types of tabs out there. I don't have one here, but some tabs are longer and may span this entire portion. So these are made exactly the same as far as material and finish goes. There's just slight differences to accommodate whatever type of setup you're running. Okay, so one of the reasons that we need a spacer on this when we're running our clutch is because most of the grips that are readily available on the market today, these are Crane Technology grips, which is what most people use. You can see it's just flat here, all right? So because that's flat, this cannot sit up against this clutch. The clutch is going to be spinning in the back, and there's going to be friction, and it's going to be hitting these grips. Also, we can see down here this piece coming off the clutch about 1 inch. So what this spacer does is it creates the necessary distance between the clutch and your grips so that it can function properly. All right, so the way that this spacer installs so that we can use our grips, we have four holes in the clutch itself, and that's where our grips and our spacer is going to attach. Because this is a GE clutch, we have a GE style tab. The tab goes on here first, and what we can see is it's sitting between the posts on the top of the rotor housing. And then once that's in place, our spacer will go over top of that tab. I'm going to put one screw in here just to hold this in place so I can get my hands out of the way. But you can see here now our tab's in place and our spacer's in place. And what that's going to allow us to do now is mount our grips. So of course the screw I put in wouldn't be there, but you can see these grips would sit flush on the back of that spacer now. The bolt that we put in, or the screw that we put in, would go right through our grips and right into the back of that spacer, and then thread into the clutch itself. And what that would do is that would allow this to rotate freely and not hit our grips at all. All right, we've installed our grips here just to kind of show you how this looks here. As you can see, it's a very nice look to it, nice and clean finish. The anodization looks very nice. You can see our screws or bolts going through the grips and into the back of the clutch. Tab sits nice and flush on there, and that gives you a good look at what these spacers look like.